Next up is Kevin Banks Jr. He is a 2018 alum of Chicago Scholars. He is from the North Lawndale neighborhood and attended Lindblom Math and Science Academy. Kevin graduated from the Milwaukee School of Engineering and is the CEO and founder of Just the Right Amount LLC. Kevin also serves as the communications chair for Chicago Scholars Alumni Leadership Association. Kevin, take it away.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you all for joining us. And the title of my piece is Raising the Bar, Setting the Pace. And the 2018-2019 regional chairperson is? It is March 22nd, 2018, and I just landed with my university chapter of the National Society of Black Engineers, otherwise known as NSBE. NSBE is the largest student-governed organization in the world. After a 90-minute bus ride, we arrive at our hotel in the early morning hours in Pittsburgh, site of the 44th annual convention. While checking in at the hotel, I reflect on my history and how this very moment was foreshadowed almost 30 years ago. In the fall of 1989, while at the University of Illinois at Chicago campus, my parents met. The way the story was recounted to me, my father, Kevin Banks Sr., arrived on campus for a professional development event hosted by their school's NSBE chapter. After finding a seat, he proceeded to leave his book bag in his chair and go mingle with other students. When he returned, my mother, Rhonda Banks, was sitting in his seat. An intense conversation would ensue, and my father asked, "Why are you sitting in my seat? Did you not see my book bag in the chair?" My mother would famously reply, "Book bags do not belong in chairs, they belong on the floor." That is where my connection to NSBE began. After checking in, I find myself deep in thought about what is to follow in the next few hours. Today, I begin the election process for the 2018-2019 Region 4 chairperson position. Growing up as a young Black male, gifted in math and science, I always felt different than my peers. I struggled with a sense of belonging because I enjoyed graphing functions in math class and applying Ohm's law in physics class. However, being here at the NSBE convention with over 10,000 Black and Brown engineers somehow made me feel right at home. On the first day of the convention was the speech portion of the election process. I arrived at the convention center 20 minutes early to place campaign flyers in the roughly 250 seats set up around the auditorium. My slogan, raising the bar, setting the pace, facing each individual that decides to take a seat. As the morning's proceedings get underway, my nerves increase. Before leaving my hotel, I was unable to print a physical copy of my speech. So while I wait for my name to be called, I'm hoping that one of my peers arrive with a copy. I rehearse my speech in my mind when I hear, "And now, Kevin Banks Jr., candidate for regional chairperson, will give his speech." When I step to the podium and take out my phone to read my speech, my eyes get blurry. I take a deep breath, focus my eyes, and begin reading. "Brothers and sisters, I stand before you today not as a candidate for regional chair, but as an agent of progress and change for our society." After three agonizing minutes where my mouth was dry and I stumbled occasionally over my words, my speech is done and I can step off the podium. As I get back to my seat, my friends in my chapter tell me that I did a great job. Now comes the hard part, Q&A for each candidate tomorrow. For the rest of that day, I have my chapter drill me with questions about my platform and the roles and responsibilities of the regional chair. When I lay down to sleep that night, although feeling prepared, questions somehow linger in my mind. Am I good enough? Am I even qualified? I've never served on the regional level before. Will this even work? I awake the next morning with those questions still on my mind, entering the Q&A session. My opponent for chairperson is a two-time regional leadership member from Northern Illinois University. He received the first question. After responding, I'm asked the next one. What are the roles and responsibilities of a Region 4 chairperson? This question fuels my confidence, and I answer with clarity and poise. With each question thrown at me, my doubts are replaced entirely with a confidence I had never felt before. It was like someone gave me the answers to a final exam in calculus or something. I walked back to my seat, feeling nervous, yet relieved. I had done all I could do. Now, it is in the hands of the voting senators. Upon leaving the convention center with my best friend, we are approached by a current regional leader, member from NIU, where my opponent is from. With a sly smile, he says, "Overall, you did incredible for your first time running for regional leadership. Everyone loves a good underdog story." I'm shocked at his comment. I felt that I had prepared well, regardless of my first-time status. I spent the rest of the day mulling over the idea of an underdog. I've never ascribed to that title, nor those feelings. When I go to sleep that night, I had decided that if I was going to find out the results, I would need to do it with my head held high. The next day, all of the members fill into the auditorium, waiting to know who had won the elections. I sit in the front row with the rest of the candidates for various positions, anxious, but excited. After the business of the region is conducted, we finally get down to the election results. Finance chair, programs chair, treasurer, and vice chair are all announced first. And the 2018-2019 regional chairperson is, I close my eyes. Take a deep breath, my mother would say when I would practice my times tables on car rides with her as a child. And the 2018-2019 regional chairperson is Kevin Banks Jr. My eyes open in disbelief. If this experience has taught me anything, it is that limits and failure are only tricks of the mind to push me to be the best version of myself. Thank you all so much.
Oh, look at that. Woo! Woo-hoo!
All right, Kevin. Wow.